I've been in touch with several pastors. If not 99%, it's 96% of the pastors that I work with were broke, and they call it, they have a job. But job actually means just over broke or no money at all. More often than not, they don't even have transportation money. There was a time that I was one of the directors of Prayer Power Ministries, which is founded by the late Ariel Mostek. Savory fried chicken in Quezon City. And across our table, there was this gentleman, Chinese, who was introduced to me. And the witty Ariel Costes introduced me as General novales to the guy. The Chinese businessman was, it was just by passing. Hi, hello, over there. This is General Vince Novales. Kasi mukha daw ako military. But the main reason why he called me a general is because I am leading thousands of network marketing people. And to become a general, you should have 1,000 soldiers as well. So, nagtutos ako doon. And the guy said, you know, I've been wanting to go into network marketing. That time, he was flat broke. He was actually ostracized by his family as the youngest among the Chinese clan. Pinapaalis na siya doon sa kanyang bahay. And we just met at the right point in time. And the guy said, you know, I have this product that I would like to sell to network marketing. At the time, he was talking to the biggest network marketing company. At that time, it was Barclay. And they are still deliberating whether they will carry the product or not. But it so happened that we saw each other in that restaurant, the Savory restaurant in Timor. And upon introduction as general, when I was feeding farewell already, it's been nice to meet you, sir. He said that, then I was clearly introduced. Sabi ko, I just want to correct to you that I'm not a general. I'm in network marketing and I have been in the business since 1976. And if there's any way that I can help you sell your products by increasing your salespeople, I'll be glad to do that. Normally, during the time, my acceptance fee was ₱1,000,000. But in as much as the person was flat broke, I gave it to him on a different arrangement that he can pay me the royalty in designing a marketing plan. And later on, through the years, he would be able to pay me what was due. That time, he was selling his product to the Philippine Christian bookstore at about 3,000 units a month. But after I introduced and designed the network marketing system in his business, sales went up to 60,000 pieces a month. I'll tell you later. I need to put some mystery here. So from 3,000 pieces a month to Philippine Christian bookstores, that's roughly about ₱1,000,000 a month in sales. About 3 months later, upon introduction, sales went up to 60,000 pieces. At times, that's about ₱10 million a month. From ₱1 million a month to ₱10 million a month, it was rather significant. And so, the arrangement was that I'll just be receiving 1% of gross sales every month. So that was good figures. Aside from that, I'll be receiving ₱50 for every person who will register. Because to become a member of the network marketing, they have to pay something. And at that time, it was only ₱50 that I asked for. To cut the long story short, in about 10 months, we had 80,000 pastors and pastors' wives promoting our Christian products. 80,000 at 50 pesos each. It's a big sum of money. Diba? How much is that? That's about 400,000 pesos, I would say. Diba? Malaking pera. But it was never given to me. And even the 1% was not given to me. The company lasted for about, I think about 6 years. And he was able to put up a building. Napakalaki ng kanyang opisina, laki ng revenue. The revenue, according to my accountant who was there, was worth about 1.2 billion in 5 years. But the guy is very well off now. And he's comfortable. He is just one of those people that I've helped improve his life through this kind of business. I am a firm believer of Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18. And Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18. Has anyone memorized that verse?
Don't forget the Lord. Give you wealth.
The strength.
Strength.
Give you the strength.
Strength, abilities, the attributes. In your, is that NIV, Sister Lily?
I remember. Yes.
Merong abilities, merong attributes, merong strength. In her version, it is power.
Power.
So time and again, I will always stress that and make it a point that people will remember. That's why in network marketing, most people remember me for Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18. Rather than Mr. Convince, yung iba ang tawag sa akin, Mr. Power. Because
when I hold my seminar,
you make it the point that they remember me. NIV?
NIV.
But you shall remember the Lord your God, because it is He who is giving you to gain wealth. It is God who is giving us the power to earn money. So if it is God who is giving us the power to earn money, it is not a sin to become wealthy. In fact, it is a sin to be in poverty. Both riches and poverty is a state of mind. In Proverbs 23, verse 7, it says there, as a man thinketh, so shall he be. Kung ano daw iniisip natin sa sarili natin, yun daw ang mangyayari sa atin. Tama? So even that was expanded by Napoleon Hill in his book, and it became very popular saying. In one of the pages of Think and Grow Rich, it says there, whatsoever the mind of man can conceive and believe, he can achieve. Actually, galing yun sa Proverbs 23, verse 7. As a man thinketh, so shall he be. Okay? Kung ano iniisip mo, yun ang mangyayari sa'yo. Okay? If you think success, it will happen. And if you think failure, it will also happen. So you might as well think success. Because we have a God who wants us to become successful anyway. In 3 John verse 2, it says there, I wish that you prosper and succeed in all things. Three things that John has written. He said, I wish that you prosper in all things, in your health, in your wealth, even as your soul prosper. Tatlong aspects of which I am involved for so many years now, way back in 1990.